Riders ready, watch the game.
Welcome to round number four, the 2016 UCI BMX Supercross World Cup. We're here in Rock Hill, South Carolina, the United States of America. I'm Pete Dalewski. We're joined by Dr. Jason Richardson. And we're going to have all of the qualification race action for you here today. Jason, exciting race. Just two races left in the schedule before the end of the season.
Yeah, it's been a long season, but we're not done yet. And I know the riders are excited to race this track. We know it holds up well in the rain from last year, and this is a great racetrack, really fair. You can win from lane one or lane eight. So I know the guys and I know the men and the women are very excited to race this race and jump on down that hill.
Well, you see moto number one of the elite men getting into the gate. We're going to kick things off. There's our schedule for today. Right now, we're going to go into those qualifications. Later on tonight, we'll have the super final time trials for the elite women and the elite men. But first, it's all now down to these qualification runs. Jason, these riders have to make their way into tomorrow's show if they want to be able to make their way into the final.
Yeah, that's right. A little bit of a pressure cooker. Seems like there might be a bit of a technical thing going on in the gate as they're backing out. But we have Chappelle, White, Calixto Lopez, McCrory, Lacombe, Sinma, and Montenegro all lined up or about to line up on this gate. You might want to keep your eyes on Trey White. And I know Mr. Lacombe, number 190, his bike's a little bit not as normal as the rest of them. He's riding what's called an OS bike, which is oversized wheel. So that's just within the legal limit as far as wheel size. He's very tall, much taller than the other riders, so he's riding a little bit different of a bike. And then we have Kyle McCrory, kind of a non-sponsored rider from the USA who's looking to make a name for himself. And again, Trey White in lane two, who is the British champion, so who made a great pass on Kyle Evans, the Olympian, for that win. So they're just trying to stay loose and be as ready and as focused as possible for this lap.
So as the riders will get up, this will be the first of their three rounds of qualifying to try to make their way into tomorrow's qualification racing. But Jason, first moto on the gate, you're getting ready, you're getting yourself psyched up, and then they ask you to pull back. You know, what's going through these guys' minds?
And the crazy thing about that, Pete, is they actually had a bit of a break between their warm-up and now, so they've actually been sitting. I mean, they might have warmed up, you know, out on that pretty green field that we see, or maybe in the warm-up area, but they it's been a while since they've been on the track. I know the wind has picked up, so to load in the gate and then get back off, it's one of those things that can break definitely break up the flow mentally. However, that's part of the game, and a few of these guys are new to the game, but some of them have been in it for a while, so I think they're just all itching to race, and then, like I said, they're doing what they can to stay loose and focused at the same time.
So as we get things worked out, those riders are up there. It looks like they are going to load into the gate with four heat number one here. Obviously, you want to get those low points, top four, usually secure your way through. But as we've seen, anything can happen in each one of these three rounds. These motos are not scrambled. These riders will race each other three times.
Yes, each of these riders will race each other, the same group, for three times in a row to qualify into the big show tomorrow.
So here we go with moto number one for the qualifications here at stop number four in Rock Hill. Coming down that first straightaway, it's definitely a place you want to be out front. And right now it's going to be Trey White from Great Britain who carries that lead into turn number one, Jason.
Yeah, he had a really good start. Looks like McCrory popped into second over that double. Trey White with a commanding lead going over the berm jump into the second turn. Looks like McCrory's getting passed by Montenegro. The Argentinian riders are known to be quite savvy on the track, but Trey White just running away with it. McCrory fighting back, getting savvy himself, going underneath Montenegro, and it looks like they'll have a pretty clean finish with White, McCrory, and Montenegro, and Lopez for the fourth.
So definitely a better start for Trey White. He's had some adversity in these opening rounds when he's got to these World Cups. He's always looked strong, but right there was a perfect finish. So we'll go right into our results list, and there you go. With Trey White taking the win, McCrory in second, and Montenegro in that third place spot. So we'll get ready for moto number two, Jason.
Yeah, we have Campos, Smith, Harvey, Sakaki Barra from Australia, Malenfant, Tizar, who's a local hero, and Zhu Wai.
So again, a good mixture of some of the younger riders, a couple of guys that have been around for some time, but mostly, just as you can see, a lot of new names here in today's qualifications. And here we go with the start for moto number two in our first round.
They're off to a good start. Looks like Smith in lane two got out pretty good, but I see Sakaki Barra. He's in that yellow jersey from Australia, taking a commanding lead with Rock and Roll Cole Tizar on the outside in third. Sakaki Barra jumped a little bit of an overjump, but again, a commanding lead over the berm jump. Smith and Tizar going at it on two on that two and three spot. Smith holding off Tizar. Sakaki Barra looking like he might be getting a little bit tired or something, or wobbly. I don't know what happened there. Smith is putting on the pressure as Cole holds down that third. But we have Sakaki Barra holding on to the first, Smith, and then Tizar for the third with Malenfant in the fourth from Canada.
Yeah, it was a good battle there in second and third. Tizar is a local. Maybe a little pressure. He saw him case just a little bit on that berm jump, but still was able to come back with a third solid finish. As you can see, there is the official result from qualification round number two.
So it doesn't take much to get caught in some of these rounds with these big tracks. So a small mistake will definitely get you in trouble. For the third rack, we have Bernhardt, Gustafson, Seegers, Posey, another local hero, McLean, Marquardt, and Bunkayai from Thailand. This ought to be a good one, Justin Posey being a favorite here in Rock Hill. He's already standing up and poised. We have Gustafson, another USA rider, in lane two. So a diverse group with the guy from Thailand in lane seven. So looks like Posey off with a good start. Gustafson putting some pressure on him on the inside, but he said, no, Posey, let's keep it clean. Posey, I know the crowd's going crazy out there for him. Posey, Gustafson, as they go over the berm jump, looks like we have Posey, Gustafson, Marquardt from Switzerland in third, and then fourth, we can't really make out since one, two, and three have such a commanding lead. Pete?
Bernhardt from Germany's in that fourth place spot right now, but it's all Justin Posey coming down that line. It's going to be a little bit of a charge from Smith, but to the line it'll be Justin Posey, Gustafson, excuse me, and then Marquardt and Bernhardt really close right at the line with Marquardt getting that third place spot.
Yeah, that was a good race. It looks like the Gustafson and Posey could have locked elbows a little bit in that first straight, but they kept it clean, and they'll be free to race the next round. So Posey, Gustafson, Marquardt, Bernhardt, Seegers, McLean, and Bukiai from Thailand. So that was a pretty diverse group we had there, Pete.
So moto number four in these elite men, Messier, McConaughey, Van Gorkum, Palmer, Diaz, Bosco, and Fleming. So new names, and then Yelle Van Gorkum.
That's the fun part about these motos. You have some guys with a lot of experience and some of the younger ones from the junior ranks coming up to elite men. So it's a really, you never know what you're going to get in these motos. Like I said, a diverse group with experience and from where they are, where they live.
Yeah, you can't get much more experience than Yelle Van Gorkum, silver medalist at the Olympics. Didn't have a qualification spot up till now, so he's in hard qualification motos. Right there, he gets the hole shot, so it looks pretty good for him as he leads the pack into turn number one with the Canadian of Palmer just behind him in that second place spot, and then McConaughey from New Zealand in third.
Yeah, the New Zealanders have been coming on strong. They always have at least one or two that are very competitive internationally. It looks like Palmer's putting some heat on Yelle Van Gorkum. He's saying, you may have a silver medal, but don't think that this is going to be easy. Gorkum, Palmer, looks like they're trading off for first and second here. Might even have a photo finish. And the third place rider taking a while will be Fleming coming in from New Zealand. Messner with the fourth from France.
So it definitely looks like those two took it a little bit easy because they had the opportunity, but definitely a good run there, first and second for those two in moto number four.
It is a bit about attrition and survival at times, Pete.
So we will get ready for heat number five with Aguirre, Sebesta, Dumont, Kronk, Granadal, Van Kamen, and Martinez. Those are your seven riders. That is your official result from heat number four.
So Palmer did get that win from Van Gorkum. Fleming from New Zealand and Messner with the fourth. The other men will have to race a little bit harder or smarter the next time. Heat number five, Aguirre, Sebeste Dumont, Kronk, Van de Groenendaal, Van Kamen, and Rojas Martinez.
So Zach DeSicco, number 189, as his fans in the USA like to call
him. Is that his nickname?
That's Zach DeSicco.
Well, Zach had a surprising race at the Olympic trials for the U.S. not too long ago. A little bit of scandal, but I would say that Sebesta will surprise most of us right now with a great start. Looks like he shot right out of there. Van Kamen had a good start, but Sebesta with a little bit of power in the inside lane going into the first corner, grabbed a couple of pedals. I know he's running those carbon fiber wheels. Most people run aluminum wheels, which is an alloy. Sebesta's running a carbon fiber rim. He says he loves them in the turns, and it's showing because he is really taking that lead. Little bit of a bobble. Looks like Van Kamen's going to capitalize on that. But Sebesta, again, in that corner, taking that line and holding it strong. Looks like Sebesta and Van Kamen. Van Kamen edges them out, Sebesta. And then the third place will be Rojas Martinez with Van Groenendaal from the Netherlands in fourth.
Yeah, I think Van Groenendaal, his first trip to the United States of America, came over with Jelle Van Gorkum. Definitely an eye-opening experience for him to be out here on that Rock Hill track, top four. Definitely solid for his first lap in a Supercross in the U.S. base. So it will be Van Kamen with the win, Sebesta in second, and Rojas Martinez in third. So we'll get ready for heat number six, Jason.
Yeah, really looking forward to heat number six with Rosa, Rios Melendez, Justin Kiemann, Nick Kiemann's younger brother, Webster, Aguirre, DuPont, and White from Canada. So this is a little bit, I would say, younger of a moto than we've seen, younger of a heat. A lot of the newer riders getting their feet wet with international competition. But these men, by no means, are lacking in speed or skill. So the starter having them on hold for a bit. They're all standing up to get ready as they are poised, waiting for that call signal.
So as the gate drops, we'll see who can pop out. Looks like it's going to be Webster from Germany with the early lead, but he's going to have a battle on the inside of him from Rosa from Australia and Aguirre from Chile. Good run here from these youngsters down that second straightaway. Let's see how things work out as they go into turn number two. Looks pretty clean for the top three, Webster, Rosa. Now Kimmen makes his way into third, and it looks like it's going to be a battle for the lead, Jason.
Yeah, Rosa looked like he was having some trouble in the second straight with a couple of, coming up short on a couple of those jumps, but he seems to have found the steam in making the move for the top spot. And Kiemann in third. Looks like Rosa, Webster, Kiemann, and Melendez. That was an interesting moto. We had a lead change, a couple of mistakes made, but again, these early rounds, they're just trying to qualify to the next round. They want to be clean, and they want to live to fight another day or tomorrow night as it is.
Yeah, so they have these three rounds. First round's got to be nerve-wracking, but you don't really have that many chances to move on, so you got to get your things together. And you see Rosa, Webster, Kimmin, and Rios Melendez did so, and we'll see how things work out for them when we move on to their second round of motos. So get ready for heat number seven. Some big names in here. Bensick, Molina, Bias, Pringers, Collins, Bunce, Ruz, and Aglendo.
Yes, Butti and Agudelo, those seem to be new names to this circuit. And we're looking, the Colombians and the Swiss ride, and the Swiss, they always put out some smart and savvy riders. So we're looking to see some surprises, hopefully. And Collins, U.S. native, he didn't go to school too far from here, a few hours away. So I know there's some people in the stands that'll be rooting for him as well. Get ready for the call. They're off. It looks like Collins coming from lane five or six. He had a great start, but he could not get over that first jump. It might be a little bit windy. Coming out of turn one, we have Molina. So it's Molina, Collins, and Bensick. Molina is known as one of the strongest guys on the track. I was overhearing some of the trainers talk about how he can squat three times his body weight, so there's no surprise that he popped out of there and was able to capitalize on that fast first straight. Collins with still a good comeback, strong second place, and Bensink in third, and we know his gates are good for obvious reasons. Molina, Collins, Bensink, and Bias from New Zealand. Looks like Krieger's from Latvia, a surprising fifth. So he's going to want to improve that position because Krieger's is normally usually a top three front runner.
So the youngster from Argentina definitely staking his claim here for top names of riders in the finish in Rock Hill. Collins in second, and Bensink, as Jason said, was in third. So we'll get ready for heat number eight. And we have the brother Webster, second youngster from Germany. He's going to be in there. And I'll let Jason handle the rest
of
it.
Yeah, so we have Webster, Inkok Song from Thailand, Tahiko, Dominguez, Kawa, Gao, Lopera, and Manaton from Great Britain. So this is a very, very international group of riders. No USA, we have some Oceania, we have South America, we have North America represented, as well as Asia. So this will be an interesting rack of guys. And Webster, yes, his brother just raced a few laps back, and I suspect he will probably most likely be a top three guy into that first corner. Pete, take it away.
So the gate drops, and it looks like it's going to be Manaton from Great Britain, who has a good start, but now he has a challenge from the inside, and it will be Dominguez from Colombia. Then Tahiko's in that third place spot for now, but a good battle. Looks like he moved up into second, but as they come into turn number two, it'll be continually Dominguez. Tahiko did move into second, and Manaton from Great Britain in three, but right now it's going to be Dominguez running away with this race, Jason.
Yeah, Dominguez just really handled that track and handled the competition. Just very minimal mistakes, straightforward point A to point B with Manaton. With Tahiko and Manaton bringing up the second and third. Webster for a strong fourth.
So you might not see all your big name stars here, but they're going to be in the super final time trials later tonight.
That's right.
So these are the qualifications. Or you see a lot of new names, as we've said. A lot of new names of riders, and you can see with these names with Dominguez, Tahiko, Manaton, and Webster. But later on tonight at 8 o'clock, we'll have that super final time trial. We'll have the top 16 overall ranked riders that are here for the elite men, top 8 for the elite women. They're going to go for the fastest lap around the track tonight. They're pre-qualified. And they will go. So we'll get ready for heat number nine.
And some of the names that aren't big now will be big later, such as Tangerief, Van Gett, Villegas, Christensen, Fala, Wolk, Green, and Homsch. And actually, Van Gett is a two-time Olympian and a very big name in the Netherlands, and Fala as well, a past Olympian. So we have some big names on this gate and some people looking to get into that big name circle, Pete.
So in lane two there, we see Twan Van Gent as the gate drops down. The power comes out from the inside and the outside, but right now it looks like it's going to be Twan Van Gent who leads this pack of riders into turn number one. We're going to have Villegas in that second place spot and maybe the young Australian Honch in that third for now. But you'll see Amelia Fala definitely battling from the back of the pack, trying to get up to the front. That's where you're going to find Twan Van Gent.
Yeah, this one was a tricky moto. You had the Australian in second in that first corner. He seems to have dropped back, but Van Gent, Villegas, and Christensen, I mean, they have been on the circuit for a while. They are no stranger to these situations, so I think their experience, the speed, just let them out. Van Gent, Villegas, Christensen, and then Wolk with Homsch, who started out in second, dropping back to fifth.
So definitely a good mix there of some of the older talent.
The experienced talent.
Yeah, those guys.
Mixing with some of the newer talent, for sure. And that's the official Van Gent, Villegas, Christensen, Wolk, and Homsch. Follow with the sixth.
So we're going to get ready for our last run, moto number 10, for the elite men's qualifications. Last moto before we head over to the women's. But there's your start list. It'll be Tugas, Ospana, Palominos, Whitfield, Shippers, Viede, Hughes, Lavaretto.
Yes, Tugas. Tugas making the jump into elite men. Whitfield, known for his very stylish ways around the track. And we know the Canadians are always strong finishers.
Well, Tugas, he's a three-quarter world champion. so he might not be the strongest finisher for right this time.
Well, he's a good starter, that's for sure. But Viede, the Latvian, had the pop, but it seems like the Colombian pops into that first corner. Ospina with the power. Ospina, Viede, Hughes. Looks like maybe Viede just overjumped or underjumped that in the first straight. Whitfield jumping into the second corner for third place. Not coming out that strong, leaving some room for the Australian. But right now we have Ospina.
These rides are packed side to side on that first straight.
And Whitfield fighting for that fourth, but I think the Canadian might have got him at the line. Tugas got him at third. So Ospina, Vieta, Tugas, and Whitfield with Hughes for the fifth.
Yeah, that moto, they were packed down the first straight. They were still together going into that last turn. Definitely a good battle there with our young riders out on the track, because that one definitely had some of the youngsters on course. And there's your official results for heat number 10 with Ospina, Vieta, and Tugas in the top three. Whitfield coming in for that fourth place.
Yeah, I suspect that moto will mix up quite a bit the next two rounds.
So we make our way over to Elite Women. First of three motos for these Elite Women in qualifying. Thori Schiebert, Smulders, Gonzalez, Curtis, Thongmi, and Sakakibara.
Sakakibara, yes, the sister of the brother, Sakakibara.
It's a family affair.
It is a family affair, and we have the Christensen, which is a brother-sister team, and then two brothers, Webster, in Elite Men, so this is a family sport at an elite level. So it looks like they're making sure the track is all ready. The women doing their final checks and preps, taking those deep breaths or maybe shaking off the nerves just a bit.
We've seen some practice earlier today. Some of these girls were having a little bit of trouble with this first jump, so it's going to be interesting to see. There was a few girls that held off actually jumping it, saying, I'm going to let the pressure of moto number one be my guide to get over to that first
nobody
jump.
Wants to mow the lawn in the middle
of
the
nobody wants to be nicknamed the gardener. But no. We will see after these elite women, they've made a long journey to here to Rock Hill, South Carolina for their stop on the World Cup Tour. Let's see how things go out as we kick it off with heat number one for these elite women.
Looks like they're off to mostly a clean start. The Thorley just pinched. The Australian had a great start, overjumped the first jump, couldn't get through the second jump, but coming out of the first turn, we have Smulders, Curtis, and Shriver. So Shriver putting on some pressure, jumping into second. Still have Smulders, now Shriver, and Curtis. 1, 2, and 3 through the rhythm section. The Australian in fourth, going in there with this. Moto is stacked and packed with bunching up in that last corner, but looks like Smulders, Curtis, Shriver, and Sakakibara with Thorley in the fifth. So that was definitely a pretty good mix of riders. Three Australians in there. Must be hard to race your countrywoman and have to make those moves when you're going for that qualifying position. So not quite a team sport. Your official results: Smulders, Curtis, Shriver, Sakakibara, and Thorley.
So good run there for heat number one. We'll move on to heat number two of the elite women. There's your start list.
Bellinger, Restrepo, Fleming, Michelson,
Tuckshare,
Priest, and Jones. Jones living with Brooke Crane when she's here in the United States, so they're training partners. Priest definitely in a lot of Supercross main events, and so they're just waiting for a clean start. As you can see, the starter signaling, they're all standing up waiting for that red light.
So as the gate drops, there's three young Canadian women. Can any of them come out with the lead? Right now, it looks like they're not going to be able to, as it looks like it's going to be Nadia Pries who gets herself the whole shot out to front
Jones.
With Jones in that second place spot.
It looks like they're just running away with it. Seems like the other women got a little held back in that first straight. A couple people didn't jump it, and so a couple people don't jump it, that gets away the other people. So Priest and Jones just running away with it, putting quite a bit of real estate between them and the rest of the pack for round one.
So Nadia Priest.
Nadia Priest with an easy win. Jones with a solid second. Tuckshare with a third. Belanger with a fourth.
So, yeah, as Jason said, one rider didn't jump in that first race. It looks like somebody also went down. Unfortunate to see, but you see that race gets strung out pretty fast. But Nadia Pries, definitely one that's been on fire on our World Cup tour. Rachel Jones is always a threat right there, was able to get second. And then Diana Tuckshir from Canada, she's had a lot of great flashes. Looks like today she's able to put it together good so far with that third place result. We have two more rounds for her to go, but definitely a motivational lap there to get top three in your first moto in a three-moto transition.
It's always nice to begin the day with a 1, 2, or 3. It helps ease the pressure going into those next two rounds of motos and also gives you a little bit of confidence getting around that track, knowing how the track races with people on it. So there's your official. Priest, Jones, Tuckshir, Belanger, Fleming, Restrepo, and Michelson, Mikkelsen. We might have lost one over that first straight as we see the women waiting to get in the gate for round for the third group. The third group being Afrimova, Kitswanis Thaisen from Thailand, Escobar, Reno, Geving, Walsh, and Liu Wei. Now, Geving and Walsh are actually undercover veterans of the sport, just not so much of Supercross. And meanwhile, we have Escobar. We know that the Colombians train hard at altitude. Again, strong finishers. And then, you know, a strong contingent from Thailand. A lot of Thailand riders coming over here, inspired by Amanda Carr and her Olympic endeavors. And they're all waiting for the starter to give them the call, focusing on getting out of the gate clean and getting over those jumps is what they want to do.
So we'll get ready for this, the third round of Elite Women. Third of three motos for them. We have the other women sitting back watching the broadcast. I know Brooke Crane's anxiously waiting at the edge of her seat to see what lady shoe we will be racing tomorrow when we get into those qualification runs. But we'll get ready here with the start of heat number three here in Rock Hill for stop four of the UCI BMX Supercross World Cup Tour.
Red means race. The lights go, and so do the girls down. So do the women down the hill over the first and second jump. It seems like most of them get out okay. Reno's in third with Geving in fourth. Afrimova, the Russian, in first with Walsh in second, or in third. Looks like Afrimova, Reno going into second, Walsh in third, excuse me, and Geving in fourth. Looks like they're strung out pretty well in that third straight. Nothing too crazy is going to happen unless something crazy happens, but we have Afrimova, Reno, Walsh, and Geving, top four, with Escobar with the fifth. That was actually a pretty clean lap. Most people got over the jumps pretty well in that first turn, or the first straight, excuse me. And so it just was a matter of just pure speed and track skill out there. So the official, Afrimova, Reno, Walsh, Geving, and Escobar, Liu Wei, and Kitswanis Thaisen will have to race a little bit harder and do a little better the next two rounds to get to make it to the tomorrow show.
So another girl, Afrimova from Russia, to come out and have a strong showing. And this is early qualification rounds. This was just one lap. But some of the names in that race were definitely some of those big name riders out there, especially Reno, Geving. As you said, they've been around for quite some time. They've raced out here a few times. So definitely a good run. And definitely good to see different parts of the world produce top-notch World Cup qualified riders.
Yes, for sure. And if you notice, that you can see the flags just above the stands blowing a little bit, and it is a crosswind. So the girls, or the women, when they come down the hill, they sometimes have to work a little bit harder to get over those jumps, those first two jumps, because they're not going as fast as they normally would be if the wind was blowing a different direction. A lot of times it's not as windy as it looks. I was actually in the stands with one of the elite women watching practice, and she was saying that when you're on the hill, it actually feels worse than what it is. So I got to think that the mindset and just thinking about the wind often makes it worse than what it is. And as a past rider, I know that is the case. But when you hit a jump and you know it's windy, you tend to tense up and go a little crooked. And I think that could be playing a role in some of the racing we're seeing here.
So right now we're going to have about a 20-minute break between these elite women and the next run for elite men. So we're going to let everybody, we know they were excited getting ready for today's racing. We're going to give you a 10-minute, 15-minute break here. We're going to go off air. We're going to come back right before qualification starts for those elite men. And we'll get you all of the racing action back live here on BMX Live TV with Dr. Jason Richardson, myself,
and you,
and me,
Pete DeLusky,
from Rock Hill, South Carolina, United States of America, for stop number 4 of the UCI World Cup. So we will be back in just a few moments to carry on with the qualification round for number 2.
Molina 4. Marin in 5, Posey 6, Van Kemen in 7, Van Gent in 8. That's, of course, according to their times posted within their heats. Then we got Palmer 9, Rosa 10, Vida 11, Smith 12, McRory 13 with Sabessa in 14, Logan Collins in 15, Yelefant Gorkum in 16. That is after your first run. And of course, if you look at the big Megatron, you'll see the results there from 16 upwards, 17, Villegas, Gustafsson in 18, Tahiko in 19, Webster 20, Tassar 21, Montenegro 22, Bentek 23, Christensen in 24. Just shows how important the qualification is. So important to get your times good as well as your finish. Marquet 25, Togas 26, Manaton 27, Kimmen in 28, Rojas 29, Fleming 30, Calixto 31, Bernhardt in 32. And keep having a look at the board. You'll see the guys all the way through. Again, super important, unless you're in the quarterfinals. And we're starting to do immediate knockout when just the top 4 go through. It's critically important to get a fast lap time in and get your points right at the same time. So the guys really going to have to put it out there in the second and third run here this evening if they want to go through to the big show tomorrow. That, of course, the finals. Don't forget, after the three runs this evening, we'll go into the time trial, a super final, to determine who is the fastest elite women and elite men on the track here in Rock Hill, South Carolina. And that, of course, the time trial, a supercross this evening. Rushes Afremova in 1, Smolders, Merrill in 2, Nadia Priest in 3, Reno in 4, Curtis in 5, Jones, that's Rachel from Australia in 6, Amelia Wells, Canada inside the top 8 in 7, and Shriver from GB in 8th place. That's your top 8. Let's have a look at 9 through 16 now. Tishara in 9, Giving 10, Sakaki Barra 11, Bellinger in 12, Escobar 13, Thornley in 14, Fleming in 15, and Lou in 16th place.
Quick reminder to all the riders out there, we want to show our love to Sam Willoughby while he's in recovery. Got a nice banner down there at the bottom of the steps. Let's get your autograph. Send some love to Sam Willoughby. A little bit over three minutes, so we get second round started.
So just under 1.5 minutes to go until we get loaded and started
hey,
on number two, Elite Men.
All right, fans, we are back.
We're back. I'm very excited for the second moto of BMX Supercross Rock Hill, South Carolina. The first moto was quite exciting. Had a bunch of new names and some old names mixing it up. Several young junior men and junior women who have jumped up to elite men and elite women for the next round.
So Jason, first round went through pretty good racing we saw. How is the action going to ramp up here for second round of motos? Riders that didn't do well versus riders that did do good.
I don't know if it's going to ramp up as much as it's going to change, Pete. I think a lot of, you know, anyone who got less than a fourth is going to want to get third or better. And anyone who got first, second, or third is going to want to be consistent. So as we have moto number one of elite men loading up again, we have Sakaki Barra, Kyle McCrory, Yelly Van Gorkum, Tyler Whitfield, Manaton Collins, and Zhu Wai. It seems like they did scramble the moto, so that means people who raced each other last time may or may not race each other this time, and this one is quite stacked, as the riders say. It's one of the motos with a few heavy hitters. What do you think, Pete?
Yeah, definitely. McCrory's looking strong. He's had really good first straightaways on these Supercross tracks. Van Gorkum, we know he's one of the top guys out there. Logan Collins, he's a whole shot specialist. So let's see how things kick off as the gate drops down. And from that middle of the pack right now, it's going to be a good run, but it looks like Yellow Van Gorkum's in behind.
Logan
whole shot specialist
with shot
Collins.
Out of a cannon. Great start. Even with the overjump of the first jump, he just handled it into the first corner. So he looks like he's walking away just a little bit in that second corner with the Olympic silver medalist behind him in second, and Whitfield with the third, and the Australian in fourth, and McCrory in fifth, who got a top three last round. So it looks like Collins, Van Gorkum, Whitfield fighting for that third, with Sakaki Barra with the fourth and McCrory with the fifth. That was definitely a stacked moto, and it'll definitely mix things up going into the third round. Seems like Van Gorkum, Whitfield, those would be good scores for them. Collins was in the he needed that score. And McCrory's going to have to work on that third moto because with it, he's going to be right on the bubble for qualification. Official results, Collins, Van Gorkum, Whitfield, Sakaki Barra, and McCrory. Manaton and Zhu Wai rounding out 6 and 7 for the first rack of elite men.
So definitely a good run there for Logan Collins. Whole shot specialist keeps that tradition going. He was able to make it through the first turn as well without sliding out. That's definitely always a good thing. So we'll get ready for the start of heat number two with Dominguez, Van Kimmen, Sebesta, Tizar, Gustafson, Kawa, and Messner.
Yes, three USA riders, four USA riders in here. They are used to racing each other. I don't know if that's going to be a good thing or bad thing in this moto. Sebesta, Rock and Roll, Cole, Tizar, the local, Gustafson, with Van Kamen, and then, of course, Dominguez with that lane one pick. So the Colombians definitely strong and definitely good finishers, training at altitude, most of them, as they wait for the red light. Van Kamen looks like he had a great start. Great start. Gustafson coming over from the outside, looking like he is pushing his weight around with Sebesta sandwiched between the two. But it looks like Dominguez is in front. Gustafson looks like he's working to pass into second, take over Sebesta on the inside. We have Dominguez, Sebesta, and Gustafson. Gustafson seems to be falling back. Sebesta taking over that second place. Van Kamen drops back to fourth. Rock and Roll Cole Tizar going for the third with Gustafson. It seems like one of a USA BMX moto right here with all the US riders. Dominguez very happy with that first. Sebesta, Tizar, Gustafson, and Van Kamen. That was a lot of mixing up between that second and fifth place positions, and definitely worth the work for the top three, that's for sure.
Yeah, a lot of back and forth action there. Just good position swapping. And worked out best for, you see, Dominguez, Sebesta, and then Tizar impressive out of that last turn, getting the third place just ahead of Gustafson and Van Kamen. So we'll get ready 4, heat number 3. Again, a good mixture of the riders would be Viede, Malafon, Kimmen, Green, Mute, and Icon, and Inkhoksong
from Thailand. Looks like we are missing a couple of riders from this moto.
Yeah, it's going to be White from Canada is going to be sitting out this time.
Oh, okay. Okay, so unfortunately someone did not make it through. But Melenfant with the first pick, I believe, having a good showing in the first moto. Justin Kiemann in lane 3, known for his track skills and track speed. Gates off. Looks like Vide with a great start, straight out to the front, picking up a bike length, going into the first corner with Melenfant and Kiemann rounding out the top three. Vide just walking away, going over the berm jump with a little bit of flair. Coming out of that second turn, very strong. Vide, Melenfant, and Kiemann. Looks like things are not going to change too much, barring anything catastrophic. But they all seem pretty spread out and relatively comfortable in those positions. So we're going to have Vide, Melenfant, and Kiemann top three, with the fourth place rider being Green from Australia.
So definitely a good run there for the Latvian. Good performance from from Melenfant from Canada and Kiemann from the Netherlands, top three.
And Inkhoksong with the fifth, which is definitely improvement from the first moto finish, which I believe he may have gotten a sixth or seventh, so he looks like he's climbing up as well. Wind blowing just a little bit as we see on those flags above the stands on this qualification day, clearing off the track before the next group of riders get in the gate. We have the Swiss rider crossing the finish line. He got hung up somewhere on that track. He's definitely not happy about that. He's definitely going to want to show up that third round looking for a first place, most likely to qualify out to race tomorrow. Official results from that moto: Vede, Melenfant, Kiemann, Green, Inkhoksong, Bute, and White. So Bute and White definitely have some work to do on that third round with those finishes. Inkhoksong working his way up the ranks.
So this beautiful overview of the track here in Rock Hill as we get ready for heat number 4. Here's our start list: Ospina, Villegas, Fala, Chappelle, Lacombe, Campos, and Guire.
Those are the guys. Ospina had a great lap last time. Villegas, Fala, the Olympian, Chappelle, Lacombe, Campos, and Aguirre from Chile. Don't see too many people from Chile, so it's always nice to get a good rounding out of nations in these races. Again, a lot of the junior men jumping up into the elite men ranks for this next Olympic season, as it were. But right now what matters is this moto in Rock Hill, South Carolina, for the UCI BMX Supercross. They're off to a good start. Looks like Ospina, a little bit late out of the gate, but had the legs to get to the first turn first. So it's going to be Ospina, Chappelle, and Fala. Top three, looking like Fala Bushley jumping past Chappelle into the second corner for the second place. Ospina was walking away with it, got a little bit ahead of himself, goes down, taking out someone with him. Now we have Villegas all by himself. The Argentinian says, thank you, I will take it. As we have Lacombe in second and Aguirre in third from Chile, Campos in fourth, and Chappelle in fifth. So I know that is disappointing for Ospina. He had a first, he was working on another first and went down all by himself in the rhythm. It happens to everyone. Unfortunately, not the place you want to happen. You see him praying. He's grateful he's able to cross that finish line in one piece, and I'm sure he'll come back, but that does mess his points up, and he's definitely
going to have to put it together that third round, and hopefully that's not lingering in his psychology heading into the third round.
That was one of those catastrophic disasters that you were talking about just earlier. Going
barring anything catastrophic, unfortunately, Ospina had something catastrophic happen to him and ended up with the seventh. But Villegas, Lacholm, Aguirre, and Campos will be your top four from that round.
Yeah, Fala, definitely not where he wanted to be. He was riding strong, puts him back in sixth, so he's going to be one of those riders that needs to have a strong third round. So we'll get ready here for our next start list as the riders are lined in the gate. It'll be Sidmok, Kringers, Humpsch, Martinez, Palominos, McConey,
and Aguirre.
That's the other brother. I want to call him McGuire. I'm not as fancy as you.
I believe that's how you say it in Chile.
It sure is.
McConey, Palominos, Martinez, Holmes, Kriegers, and Sinma. So definitely a list of names we will all be well served to learn as these are the future superstars of the sport that will eventually one day be sitting out and waiting for their time trials in the future. But right now they're anxiously waiting that red light because red means race, and they are off again. Down the hill over the first jump. Someone's pedaling in the air. Looks like the Latvian's going to squeeze in there with a couple of cheater pedals into the first turn. Kriegers followed by Palominos and Holmes. Holmes jumping into second over the berm jump. That will be Kritos, Palominos, and Holmes in third. Palominos riding very strongly in second. The Australian in third, but Kriegers with a little bit more experience, a little bit more international flair, so to speak. Teammates with Maris Strombergs and Vide. So we have Kriegers, Palominos, Holmes, and Sima with your top four, and Martinez and Aguirre rounding out five and six.
It's a big young group of Australians that are here this weekend. And we've seen one or two of them on the circuit before, but they've all been brought over by one of the Australians' finest.
Yes, Luke Medill, gentleman I used to race quite a bit back in the day, and Luke's doing a great job of farming up and mentoring and coaching and helping these younger riders learn their way around the world, literally, with international competition, getting the experience, and maintaining a poised mindset. A lot of these young Australians are very strong down the first straight and have really good fundamentals. We see McConey rolling in, definitely not happy about that finish. Going down is never good, but we're always happy to see someone get off the track on their own. Healthy and in one piece. He does have a couple of scrapes, but that's why they wear all the protective gear, the helmet, the knee pads, and the elbow pads. So the official results from that moto, Kriegers, Palominos, Holmes, Sima, Martinez, Aguirre, and McConey from New Zealand.
So get ready for heat number six. Those riders are anxiously awaiting their start as they're loaded in the gate. The Molina, Von Gent, Rosa, Bias, Webster, Kronk, and Vasco.
Yes, and Molina, he is just a powerhouse. So this would be a good matchup, Molina and Van Gent. They're both known for their great gate starts and their first straights. I suspect they may walk away from the crowd. But as you said, we have that young, strong Australian contingent. We have two of those men on the gate right now as they're anxiously awaiting the red.
I want to go on yellow.
If you go on yellow, you're going to be late. Again, we have Molina and Twan Van Gent into the first corner. Van Gent actually had a little bit better of a start, but a Molina with the power down the first straight and the inside lane. They are leaping into that second corner, one and two. Molina and Van Gent. Webster in the third. Looks like we have Van Gent catching up a bit to Molina, throwing a little bit of flair into that last corner. Nonetheless, Molina's going to take it wire to wire and win this one with Van Gent and Kronk. Bias and Kronk with the photo finish, and Webster for the fifth. Webster's not going to be happy about dropping back. However, fifth is better than sixth. And Vasco, unfortunately, will have to take the seventh.
From Alatis in heat number six.
The sun is shining down on this beautiful track. We know it holds up in the rain from last year. Needless to say, it is holding up in the sun even better. Definitely looking forward to the laps we have coming up. We have some time trial specialists tonight, but right now we have a group of elite men and women vying for qualification positions for those coveted race positions tomorrow night. Again, official results, Molina, Van Gent, Kronk, Bias, Webster. Nice to know that Kronk and Bias, that was figured out with the photo finish. Webster with the fifth, Rosa, and Vasco, who was pounding his fist on his handlebar with that seventh place.
So get ready for Heat 7. Smith, Harvey, Bensink, Earhart, McLean, DuPont, and Bunkhaiyai.
Bunkhaiyai from Thailand.
How about Bunkhaiyai?
Doing his best to do his country proud. Josh Smith with the pole position, lane one. So he had the first pick, my guess is, and he chose lane one because he wants that inside line into the first corner.
I think he's ready.
They are ready.
He's ready. He's been standing up for 3 minutes.
Red means race. And everyone has a little bit of different of a style, but we see the Australian coming from the outside. Will Smith be able to pinch him off? It does look like he was able to. So we have Smith with a clean move on McLean, and now McLean is dropping back from first to third in the second corner. So we have Smith, Bernhardt, McLean. Bernhardt looking very strong from Germany. Smith showing them what's up, as they say in the US. So we have Smith, Bernhardt, and Bensink rounding out the top three. McLean dropping back to fourth. He had a great start, but it looks like he might have to go to his coach, Luke Medill, and say, hey, coach, what happened? And I'm sure Luke will tell him.
What's he going to tell him? Well, they got a handlebar to the buttocks coming out of the first turn. A little bit of boost from Smith. Smooth edged
Smith
him out of the
might
way.
Have given him a little booster shot. Might have given him a little booster shot.
But whatever
shot
it takes to get that top
so
spot.
Smith, Bernhardt, Bensink, McLean, Harvey, DuPont, Bunkhaiyai, and Roos from Chile. That will be your final result from run two, heat number seven.
So heat number eight, those riders are getting ready to load in the gate. It'll be Posey, Palmer, Montenegro, Lopez, Marquardt, Van de la Groglen, Diaz, and Lopera. So there's your start list.
Full rack of elite men. USA, Canada, Argentina, Colombia, Switzerland, Netherlands, Colombia. So definitely a north versus south contingent on the gate. Posey, local hero in lane one. Posey is poised and ready to go.
From the bird flu. So on the inside, it looks like Posey gets out, moves over a little bit. But right now, it's going to be from that middle of the track. It's going to be
Montenegro, Marquardt, and Posey. Posey gets back up to second, but Montenegro has a nicely jumping into that second corner, followed by Posey and Palmer in the third. I'm not sure if Posey's going to press too hard on Montenegro with that first. I think he just wants to qualify. Montenegro always wanting to be up front. Oh, and Palmer putting some pressure on Posey now, so it might be a three-way finish here. But Montenegro, Palmer, Posey, Marquardt, and I'm sure Mama Posey's going to get on Justin's case for letting up a little bit at the finish line because every point counts.
Did you know Ty Dolla $ign has a new song out called Three Way?
No, I didn't know that.
All right, well, I thought you might.
Thank you,
like
Pete.
To know that. Check it out on iTunes.
Or you can check out the Gold Medal Mindset podcast on iTunes.
No, thank you. Okay. So there's your official results from heat number eight. When I get asked to be on it, which will be never. I'm not very good.
Pete, you can always be a guest.
No, I'm not.
You can always be a guest.
No, but anyway, back to why we're here, Jason.
We're here because this is Rock Hill, this is BMX, this is the UCI Supercross, and this is run two, heat number nine, with Trey White, Christensen, Melendez, Agudelo, Fleming, DeMont, Lavarado, and Gao. I almost said Flemington because I'm from New Jersey, and there's a place called Flemington, New Jersey.
I've been
that
there.
Race. So I'm sorry, Fleming.
What about Richard Flemington? Richard Fleming.
Trey White,
is he
lane
from England?
One. He,
is it in the UK?
He won his last moto, earned that pole position shot. He says, I want the inside line. They're all getting ready, locked and loaded. Red means race. Trey White with a good start, very strong. Swiss rider on the outside. Trey White taking it very strongly into the first corner with White, DeMont, and Christensen. DeMont just sneaking in on Christensen in that first turn as they jump into the second quarter. We have White, Christensen, and DeMont. Someone's challenging DeMont for that third, but I don't know if it's going to be enough. White stretching it out just a bit. Christensen, Melendez now. Melendez in third, challenging for the third. White, Christensen, DeMont, and Melendez. DeMont and Melendez for the photo. Agudelo for the fourth. And that will be how that moto rounds out. Trey White looking very strong, running on some good momentum from the British champs and the last European champs. He's definitely been getting in some finals, won the British champs. And I think he has something to show, not only the world, but British cycling as well, as he is riding very strongly. And we'll see if he could take it in tomorrow. The sun is shining bright here in Rock Hill, South Carolina. We have a breeze blowing. It is blowing the flags, and as we've mentioned before, sometimes you feel a little bit more on the hill than you'd like. Official results from run 2, heat 9. Trey White, Christensen, DeMont, Melendez, Agudelo, Fleming, Lavorado, and Gao from China. That's run 2, heat number 9. It's got for the final run
now. So now we'll move on to heat number 10, the last of the second round of motos here for the elite men. Tohiko, Tugas, Webster, Wong, Hughes, Sigrus, Shippers, and Tangareffi. Definitely, Brandon Tohiko from Australia has been one of those riders. He's had a lot of fast laps out on the track. He hasn't been able to be ultra consistent. We'll see how things go for him today as he's lined up right there inside on lane one. Tugas from Canada, also another strong rider. Let's go here with the start for their second run. So from the inside, see a little bumping and banging. Tugas gets out. Tohiko's in the back. Yeah, right now, it looks like Tugas is going to be leading them into turn number one.
Tugas got out, shut down Tohiko pretty well, but that's okay because there's always another Australian willing to fight it out, as that guy, Hughes, the Australian, jumps past Tugas. So we have Hughes and Tugas, one and two, going into the last corner. Tugas putting a little bit of pressure on him, but it's not going to happen. Hughes, Tugas, and Webster, one, two, and three into this moto. Tohiko had lane one. I'm sure he's not too happy with the fourth. He'll take it. But Hughes, Tugas, Webster, Tohiko, Seegers, Shippers will be top six in the, coming from that moto. That was an interesting lap. I saw how Tugas came out of that gate and just really got going. Tohiko, as you mentioned, the consistency is important. He wasn't that consistent, and it showed during that moto, unfortunately. Official results: Hughes, Tugas, Webster, Tohiko, Seegers, Shippers, Wolk, and Colorado Tangarife from Colombia. That was run 2, heat 10 for elite men. I think we're going to switch gears now and head into run 2 for elite women.
Elite ladies? Girls?
We have Reno, Curtis, Geving, Escobar, Jones, Kit Wanesteisdien, and Michelson from Canada. Pete, who's your favorite in this moto?
I'm going to go with Amanda Geving. She's been one of those riders on the circuit for a really long time. She made her big push for the Olympics 4 or 5 years ago. She had a couple of crashes, and I think she just settled in for being, just knowing her place in BMX. She wanted to make a big push for it, and then she decided just to race on the U.S. national level. Definitely interesting to see, and she's been one of those riders that's been consistently out. She lives in Florida. They have a great state program, and she's always out there racing all kinds of events out there, and she's usually one of the top riders, and she's just a really nice person. I think she's also a firewoman. So, you know, not only nice on the track in her, you know, real life or real job, she's out there helping people, saving lives, and, you know, yeah, serving the community. So those ladies are lined up in the gate. We'll get things kicked off for the second round of Elite Women here in Rock Hill at stop number 4, the UCI BMX Supercross World Cup.
Reno wheelies out of the gate. Looks like Curtis gets the jump off the line, and Pete's favorite, Amanda Geving, challenging Curtis. She's coming out of the corner in second, so we have Curtis and Geving, followed by Reno in third as they go around the second corner. Curtis on that nice blue frame, followed by Geving on that pink frame. She seems to have dusted the cobwebs off quite well from that first round, and Reno in third. Jones looks to be in fourth, and that's about how they're going to finish, barring anything catastrophic.
So definitely a strong run there from Curtis from Australia, Geving with that second place finish, Reno, then Jones will be in fourth, but a good lap there for the ladies as they kick things off here in the second round of Elite Women. Their second time around the track, two more rounds to go for the two more motos to go for these Elite Women. And there's your official results.
Official results, Curtis Geving, Reno Jones, Michelson, Escobar, and Kit Wanitsaisen from Thailand.
So we'll get ready for moto heat number two, qualification run number two for the Elite Women. And again, we get to see the young Russian Afremova, who's strong in their first run. Walsh, Sakakavara, Smulders, Froley, and Thongmi. Those are our ladies that are going to line up on the gate. The young woman from Colombia, unfortunately, will not be making her way onto the gate this time. That's Restrepo.
Yes, Afremova won her first moto quite strongly. Thorley made a strong showing. We have two Australians in this moto. Smulders, always strong, always in the mains at these supercrosses. So this will be quite a contested lap. As we see, they come down the hill quite well, getting over the first two jumps. We see Sakakibara, Smulders, and Afremova. So Afremova winning the first lap. Now she's in third. Smulders, consistent as always, in second. Sakakibara running in first, maybe left that turn a little too open for the veteran of Smulders to come through. Those Dutch are known for the track speed and known for those textbook fundamental maneuvers. Smulders, so followed by Sakakibara and Afremova, and Walsh with the fourth. Thorley will have to settle for the fifth. So I'm not sure if she's going to be Thorley disgusted or thoroughly okay with that.
We will see. They have one more time to make it around. And here are your official results from that second lap of Elite Women. Definitely good racing there, but you'll see it would be Smulders, Sakakibara, Afremova, Walsh in the top four.
Yes. Yeah, that was a good race. Sakakibara had a lot of speed down that first straight, and Smulders just was able to capitalize on Sakakibara going too wide in that second corner. And that just goes on experience. But run two, heat three, we have Schreiber, Priest, Gonzalez, Tuckshire, Fleming, Liu Wai, and Bollinger from Canada. So we have seven people in this gate, all vying for that top three. Top four position. Top three are a little bit safer than top four. We have the British cycling young woman on lane one next to Priest. Priest gets out a little bit crooked, shuts down the girl next to her. British cycling taking it to the front quite nicely. Priest looking like she got stuck in third, gets back up to second. So Shriver, Priest, Tuckshire from Canada, one, two, and three. Shriver looking very stylish into that second corner, coming out very strong with a commanding lead. Price looking to play some catch up. Not quite a pretty lap as she's had before, but definitely maintaining that second place position with Tuckshire in third. So Shriver, Priest, Tuckshire, Shriver looking back saying, yes, this is how it's supposed to be done. Fleming with the fourth, Lou with the fifth.
So that'll be the second run for the Elite Women. That'll be the end of their qualifications. As we move over, we'll probably have a short break before the Elite Men get back on track. But we will get those official results from that last round for the Elite Women. And you see it was Shriver, Priest, Tuckshire, and Fleming were your top four.
Canadian Tistra in three and Fleming.
That was a good second round. I like that they scramble the motos so that it's not the same people racing the same people all the time. Mixes it up quite a bit. And then it also makes the points situation qualifying less predictable, so it makes these riders have to race each round hard.
Yeah. So we have about a 18 minute break before the racing concludes. We will take a 15 minute break ourselves. We will be back to get things kicked off for qualification run number 3 here from Rock Hill, South Carolina for the UCI BMX Supercross World Cup stop number 4. We'll get you those. Third round, Jason, the heartbreak round where riders get to figure out if they're going to move on the program. You can see the low points overall right now. It doesn't mean much until we get those third round motos up. Who's racing who? But it looks good for guys like Molina, White, Dominguez, Collins, and top 3 points going in that third round is usually a pretty good thing. So we will be back in 15 minutes to kick off the third round here for the elite men, and then we'll go into the third round of elite women from here in Rock Hill.
See you in 15.
Matthew, we've got in 17 through 24.
Good, Kaisa Kakabara out of Australia, along with Andrew Hughes in the 17 and 18. Kristen Krieger from Latvia in the 19. Jacob Bernhardt out of Germany on the 20. Niels Bensink on the 21, Cole Tizar, and Kenny G on the 22 and 23 out of the United States. And Australia's Brandon Tejico in the 24 spot. 25, a Gabby Malafat out of Canada. 26, Zach Van Kammen out of the USA. Justin Kimmen, younger brother to the world champion, on the 27. Tyler Whitfield looking good in 28 out of the USA, along with Kyle McCrory. Got Simon Marquardt in the 30 out of Switzerland, another Australian, Shane Rosa in the 31, and New Zealand's Michael Bias sitting on the 32. Cristobal Palomino, out of Chile in the 33, Jonathan DeMont, the Swiss rider on 34, Juan Angel Rios out of Colombia in the 35, Jai Hunch sitting in the 36 in a transfer position, Francisco Rojas in the 37 out of Chile, Diego Arboleda out of Colombia in 38, TK Tristan Cronk out of Australia on the 39, and younger brother Axel Webster in the 40 out of Germany. 41, Tom Senma out of Australia, Miguel Calixto from Colombia in the 42, Curtis Manitom from Great Britain, along with Jaden Fleming from New Zealand in the 43 and 44, Damien Lacombe, the French transplant to USA in the 45, Josh McLean, Wouter Seegers, and Lockie, Lachlan Harvey in the 48, the last transfer spot out of this group.
So there's your top 48, and they obviously are going to be on the bubble. 40 through 48, they've got a lot of guys challenging for those positions going into the third run here this evening. And remember, only 48 to go through to make it 64 tomorrow. The ladies, however, this is how they look. Remember, only 16 to go through from the Netherlands. Meryl Smelders holding on to the first place. Leanne Curtis out of Australia in 2, Nadia Priest in 3, Bethany Schreiber in 4, Natalia Afamova in 5, Shayla Reno 6, Saya Sakafagabara in 7, Amanda Giving in 8.
Dana Tuckshire out of Canada sitting in 9 right on the bubble. Rachel Jones out of Australia in the 10, Amelia Walsh from Canada in the 11, Zoe Fleming from New Zealand in the 12, Tyler Thorley out of Australia on the 13, Jan Liu in the 14, Andrea Escobar from Colombia in the 15, and Megan Belanger in the 16, out of Canada.
So there it is, those are the last few on the bubble. They're gonna have to keep working because the girls are gonna wanna get those places into tomorrow's final. Racing starts again, plus minus 10 minutes time, 6:30. Big shout out to one of the youngest photographers on the circuit, Obviously, Mr. London. Jerry, good to see you, buddy. Lovely to have you here. Nice to be on home soil here with Jerry London, the legend of BMX. And a big welcome, buddy. A big thank you to the boys and girls from Box. Of course, doing the plates once again here for the UCI.
Maybe after the next person goes. Yeah, like if your feet's changed, like somebody has to be two people in the hot seat to actually get interviewed.
Yeah. Okay.
out there, will they have somebody telling me?
Camera person.
No. I'm going to try a new audio thing. Can I test each one of you individually? Yeah. So start with you.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello. 1, 2, 3, 8, 19, 12, 13, 14, 15. UCI BMX World Cup. Sitting here with Pete Deluski drinking his Coca-Cola. He loves BMX.
Oops.
And he's burping.
Yeah, I almost threw up.
And he almost threw up. Meanwhile, back at the lab. There's.
But she might be a nice person.
She might be.
Probably not.
2.5 minutes till we kick this thing off again for round three. 2.5 minutes to round three.
We're going live on live.
So, Dr. J, we're back here live for the third round of motos for the elite men and elite women. Things are about to kick off, about 30 seconds where the riders are up on that gate, and this is the round where those riders really need to put it all together to make their way through today's program and get on to qualify for the finals day tomorrow, trying to make their way into that main event.
Yes, third round is the heartbreak grow round. They either pack their bags and go back to the truck or trailer or the airport, or they just pack their track bag and go back to the hotel in hopes for a good day tomorrow. Third round, some people are sitting on low points, so they know through regardless of how they finish, but because of the scrambling of the motos and because a few people mixed it up, there was a couple crashes in the rounds. You never know what's going to happen, and we may find some people racing as if it were the semifinal or main event in this last round because nobody wants to go home early.
So the track here in South Carolina, definitely not the most technical track out there, but you see a lot of speed. We've seen some great racing so far. What should we expect to see differently with these riders battling it out? You see our start list here for that third
run. Yeah, well, I think what we're going to see from Molina, Agudelo, Smith, Villegas, Aguirre, and Inconksong is a clean lap. As you said, the track is not the most technical. It doesn't take too much for the riders to figure the track out. However, they are able to race each other and not the track, meaning that they can just really get out there, pedal hard, and race each other and go for it versus being fearful that something might happen on the track. Molina off to a little bit of a late start, but again with the power, he has it, takes it into the first corner. Smith looking like he wants to at least get a second place in this moto as they jump into the second corner. Smith has a little bit of heat on him. I'm not sure if that sun bothers them into that corner with its setting. We sure like the view, but Molina expanding his lead into the last corner. He's running in hot. Laps 1, 2, and 3. Smith with a first, and now this will be a second. And then we have another Argentinian with the third, Villegas, followed by Agudelo for the fourth from Colombia.
So definitely a good run for Molina. He had low points, but a consistent run. Getting that top spot is going to help him get better gate pick position tomorrow when he moves into those qualifiers behind our riders who are going to ride in that super final tonight. But, yeah, definitely the way you want to end your day off. Feeling confident with a victory before you have to take the night off to go back racing and tomorrow. So Molina, Smith, a definitely impressive run from him. He'll move on. Villegas, also consistent today. Those guys will definitely be moving on the program. The rest of them will have to wait and see if things work out for them. So we'll get ready for the second run of elite men here, their third time around. And you see some big names in here. Chuan, Von Gent, Tugas, Sebesta, McCrory, McCong, Green, and Messner. Those are our riders here in moto number two, their third time around the track. Chuan Von Gent's been riding consistent. He's been in the first and second spot. Two guys from Canada has been also one of those guys out there looking good. Sebesta's been riding well. So a lot of big names. And McCrory's also rode decent today. So we'll see how that works out because These riders have to fight for low points. Now that all these top guys are going against each other, we'll see how things pan out with Twan Von Gent there on the inside, Jason, as they get ready to go on red, as you like to say.
Yeah, red means race, and McCrory has his work cut out for him. He got a really good first lap, and second lap he ended up with a fifth, so he seems to be in third going into this first corner. Von Gent coming out of the gate quite strongly and quite easily with into the first turn in first. Sebesta challenging Von Gent into the second corner, but Von Gent's going to hold him off. We have a rider go down. I'm not sure who that was in the second corner, but we have Von Gent, Sebesta, and I believe Tugas challenging Sebesta into the last corner. Sebesta's going to hold on to the second. McCrory's going to stay in fourth. I'm not sure if that's going to be enough, but definitely Van Gett, Sebesta, Tugas, and McCrory for the force. McConey, another guy who might be on the bubble. He may have made it. He may have not. Again, the scrambling of the motos do make things a little bit harder to decipher. However, it forces everyone to race every lap because you don't know how people are going to do in those other rounds. We have Messner working his way off the track. The goggles are off. He is seated and not happy about this finish. It probably looks like he will not go on for tomorrow's big event. Helmet off, a little bit of disappointment, but these riders are definitely tough and definitely resilient, so that we know he will be back probably for Sarasota and future Supercross races. Sun shining bright. Pete, who do we have this round?
Well, there's your official results. Von Gent, Sebesta, Tugas, McCrory. After we have all these runs down, we'll get our qualifiers.
I'm getting ahead of myself.
We'll get
Sorry
our riders listed who moves on tonight's out of tonight's program into tomorrow before we go to those super finals. So get ready for heat number three here in the Elite Men. It'll be Whitfield, Webster, Melafont, Van de Groffel, Kimmen.
And Aguirre from Chile. It rhymes,
one.
Pete. Aguirre from Chile.
Got it.
There you go. Now you will always remember. That's called a mnemonic.
Aguirre from Charlie.
Whitfield with the pole position on this lap. He must have finished better than everyone else in their respective motos. Whitfield, trained by Christian Bessadine, vet world champion. Looks like Kimmen with the pop, which is usually unlike him. Whitfield challenging him in the first corner. Looks like Whitfield is gaining some swagger out there, getting comfortable on this track, jumping through the sunlight into the second corner, coming out in first. That's Van Groenendaal in second. There we go. So Van Groenendaal is in second. Whitfield taking over, just expanding the lead. Looks like Melanfont passes Van Groenendaal for the second. We have Whitfield, Van Groenendaal, Whitfield, Melanfont, Van Groenendaal, and Kimmen, followed by Aguirre from Chile in fifth. Kimmen with the fourth. Those Dutch riders, we call them the clone army because they all wear orange and they all ride so fundamentally sound. A lot of them look the same. So my apologies to the Dutch riders. That was Van Groenendaal.
I'm really disappointed in Whitfield didn't do a scrub over the berm jump.
Well, I think Whitfield, with his trainer being Christian Bessarine, a very point A to point B kind of guy.
Pencil air?
Known for his efficient and fundamental riding skill, is working with Tyler Whitfield, who did get first this moto, to keep it basic and fundamental. Whitfield, Melanfont, Van Groenendaal, Kimmen, Aguirre, Webster, and Roos was the official for that moto.
So get ready for heat number four here in the Elite Men. There's 10 motos total. And we will get that start list up. Bias, Viede, Hamsch, Shippers, Lacombe, Diaz, and Fala.
So we have 7 gates out of 8 that are full. I know the riders who have that open man next to them, that open space next to them, always feel a little bit like there's less pressure on them, giving them more room. Lacombe with a great finish last round. I believe he got a second or third. So they are waiting for the call. Vede with a pop. The wheel was a little bit up, but he has the leg speed to get to that first turn in first, and he definitely had the line. So we have Vede, Shippers, and Fala. Fala, the seasoned vet. I think he needs some points, so he might be pressing pretty hard into that second corner, but Shippers shuts him down. Vede extending his lead through the rhythm section into the last corner, followed by Shippers, and Bias now challenging Fala in the last straight. Nothing like a challenge for that fourth position in the last straight. Always a shady moment. V-Day Shippers, Fala Bias, and Holmsch. Three-way photo, and Laucombe with the six. He's not going to be happy with that six, but that three-way photo finish is unreal. I cannot wait for the official on that.
Well, the official will be Bias with fourth, Holmsch in fifth, and Laucombe in sixth. As you said, Fala needed those points. He had that crash right at the end of that second round of motos. Came back with a strong finish for third. Will it be enough? We'll have to wait and see. But there are your official results. V8, Shippers, Fala, and Bias, your top four.
Holmes with the fifth. So it'll be interesting to see who's on for tomorrow night's show. The sun is shining. And run three, heat five. We have Palmer, Christensen, Calixto Lopez, Chappelle, DeMont, Ospina, and DuPont. And remember, Ospina lost it all last round when he went down in that third straight rhythm. So he had a first. He was working on another first, took a tumble, and now he's got to work for it to this third round. So hopefully he can get through and come back. We'll see how resilient he is. The starter letting him know to be ready. You see them lean back in the gate, poised. Red means race, and they're off. Looks like the Canadian was off to a decent start, but doesn't quite have the power. We see Ospina coming from the outside with Palmer in second and Lopez in third, jumping into the second corner through the sunlight. We have someone trying to go from fourth to third to second, but it didn't work. That was Christensen getting into third. Palmer still in second. Ospina keeps it rubber side down going into the last corner. What's your call to the finish, Pete?
Well, it's going to be Ospina. He's going to make it all right this time, all the way to the line. That was definitely good for him. Palmer from Canada with that second. Then it's going to be Calixto Lopez in there for third, and Christensen just gets past at the line. That's going to put him back into fourth. A good recovery there from Ospina after that horrible crash going into that third straight last time.
And you know, sometimes those crashes, they can either throw you off your game or actually get yourself in gear. And I think that's what happened with Ospina. He said, I'm not making that mistake again. Official results: Ospina, Palmer, Lopez, Christensen, and Chappelle, DeMont, DuPont. We will read off, Pete will read off all of the final results when all the motos are done to find out who goes on to tomorrow night.
So get ready for heat number six. It'll be Dominguez, Webster, Segers, Kawa, Butte, Rosa, and Fleming.
And Fleming. So seems like the motos were a bit lopsided. Earlier on, run three, we had a lot of the heavier hitters, or at least I would say the more known guys. They're all heavy hitters and elite men, but the more known names earlier on in the rounds. And so that definitely changes things, and that's going to make the qualification and the points very tight going into the next round as the starter makes the call, telling everyone to get ready. And as we all know, the start is very important. They are off down the ramp, charging over the hill. We have the Australian on the outside, and a nice double manual into the first corner with Dominguez from Colombia coming out of the first corner in first, extending his lead, jumping through the sunlight into the second corner, looking very strong. Dominguez, Webster's, and Seeger's top three as they go through the rhythm. Looking nice and clean, we have the Australian in fourth. Pete, bring us into the finish.
So coming around, another strong finish for the Colombians. This time it's going to be Dominguez, then Webster from Germany, Siggers in that third, then Rosa will be in fourth. Definitely a strong contingent coming up here for these last two World Cups from Colombia. I know the excitement from the Olympic Games with Mariana Pajón winning. Ramirez getting that third place finish. And you see young guys like Dominguez, Marin, coming up riding super strong, but you see.
Yes, Santiago Marin, I'm sorry, with the first place in that moto. Webster, Seegers, Rosa, and Buti, Fleming, Kawa. Buti, Fleming, and Kawa may not go on to the next round. My call is not official, however.
It's as official as it's going to get.
It could be. But run three, heat seven, we have Logan Collins, Yelly Van Gorkum, Bernhardt, Sakakibara, Cole, Rock and Roll, Cole, Tizar, Melendez, Tahiko, and Harvey. This one is stacked. We have a local hero. We have a gold. We have a silver medalist. We have definitely a veteran of the USA BMX circuit and the NBL circuit in Logan Collins. So this is definitely, Tohiko needs a good finish. So everyone is definitely going to be vying for that top three position to ensure they're racing tomorrow night.
So as the gate drops down, looks like a good battle there. Yelly Van Gorkum and Logan Collins battle. That lets Sekabara get out in the front. It's going to lead these riders into turn one. Cole Teaser is going to follow him around, and now it's going to be a good battle. As you see, Van Gorkum back in there in third, and then now good battle from fourth as well. So Tohiko wants to make his presence known, but they're all going to be chasing Sekabara around the track. Cole Teaser are super impressive. He's going to slide back ever so slightly, but just to be up there in third, battling Yelly Van Gorkum is good. Sekabara will come across the line in front. Tohiko in second. Van Gorkum will be third, and then Cole Teaser actually edges out Van Gorkum right at
that
the line.
That was a great lap. Sekabara and Tohiko answering the call in that third moto. Cole Teaser saying, no, man, I grew up here. I'm getting through. Collins might be on the bubble. We don't know if that's going to be enough for him. I'm sure he's going to be anxiously awaiting to see how the points fall, but that was a great race, and as we see, young champions being born as we speak. It's really cool. Sun is going down. I don't know how that's affecting the riders as they jump into that second corner, whether it's shadows or the glare. Definitely, if you wear glasses or contacts, that could affect you. But it definitely makes for a beautiful view for us here in the announcer's tower, announcer's room. The official call, Sekabara, Tohiko, Teaser, Bernhardt, Van Gorkum, Melendez, Collins, and Harvey. I don't think that's going to be enough for Collins, but definitely Teaser, Tohiko, and Sekabara will be moving on to the next round with a chance to shine tomorrow night.
Speaking of shining, our announcing room here with the wood paneling definitely.
It's a little bit. The announcing room is, you know, you never know what you're going to get. They're hosting us well. They're feeding us, which is good. The paneling's a bit much. You see that photo finish, and it gets close. This round, run three, heat eight, Montenegro, another local hero, Justin Posey, Palominos, Gustafson, Woke, Rojas, Martinez, Colorado, Tangerife, and Gao. So, full gate, quite a mixed group. Montenegro, always a strong competitor. Posey as well. Posey with a broken back, didn't even race here last year, and you know now winning motos, so definitely strong contention here of riders. Looks like Posey and Gustafson coming out quite strongly. Gustafson with a little bit of an edge, but Posey with the power and the line. Montenegro in second. Gustafson trying to edge out Posey into the second corner, but not going to work. Posey saying, no, this is my house. Gustafson holding strong. Meanwhile, we have someone challenging on the outside. Looks like Posey might be running out of steam in that third straight. Gustafson coming around. Palominos is going, yo, guys, what happened? We have Posey, Gustafson, Palominos, and Rojas. So that was – and Montenegro with the fifth. I know Montenegro was not expecting that. But I think, as we see, the third moto, anyone can rise to the occasion, and it's really about getting to that next round. Sometimes it's just the law of attrition, getting on and moving on.
So we'll get our official results here from round number eight, the third time around. But you see Justin Posey takes the win. Gustafson in second, Palominos in third, and Rojas Martinez in there for the fourth. As Jason said, Montenegro's been riding consistent, but fifth place in this third round is going to put him on edge. We'll see how things turn out after these next two rounds of motos to see who moves on. So heat number nine, their third time around, Trey White, Kronk, Benzik, Mark Kurt, Van Kamen, Montan, Campos, and Zai. Woo? You? Why not?
Zhu Y.
That's one of those elusive Pokemon guys.
It's an elusive name. It's an elusive name, but he's got a name and he showed up, which is what's important.
So who showed up is the real Trey White. He's had two great runs so far today, two victories. Let's see how he can round things off as we get ready for his third round around the track here in Rock Hill, South Carolina. Let's get ready for Race on Red. It's going to be my new line. And it looks like he's racing on red all the way to the front right now from the inside.
Trey White is going to have
a good battle.
Sorry about that, Pete. Van Kamen had a great pop. Trey White got out good but a little crooked, but I got to tell you, that leg speed and those, he is firing on all cylinders, jumping to that first corner on first. Van Kamen getting a little heat from the Australian in the second corner as Trey White pulls away. What do you say, Pete, as they bring us through the last turn?
So Trey White, it's going to be Trey wins for him today as he comes across the line with that victory. Zach the Sicko, definitely a sick day for him. Another top three finish this time with a second, and then crunked it up from Australia in there for the third.
Crunk was getting crunk, and Trey White, yes.
Maybe he had one of those new crunk monster energy
good drinks. Definitely strong finishes for sure.
And you see there, Ben Sick, great competitor, shaking hands with his fellow riders. But it's going to be Trey White who takes the win. Van Kamen in second, Kronk in third, and Bensick rounds off that last moto with a fourth.
What a great day Van Kamen has had. Strong all day, hole shots at least to the first or second jump, and top threes. He's going to be very happy about moving on to the next round. Run three, heat 10, the last one for elite men. We have Hughes, Kriegers, Sinma, Laborato, McLean, Zuleta, Munera, and Bunkayai. So an interesting group. We have Kriegers, three Australians, two Colombians, one person from Thailand. So a very international crew here. I suspect Kriegers might have had the top qualifying position but chose lane two anyway. That's a dangerous thing with those tricky Australians in lane one. They're known to get out very strongly out of the gate. As we see right here, as they're going two abreast into the first corner. Pete, what do we have?
We have McLean, we have Hughes, we have Sinma. Those are your top three riders. They're all from Australia. It's like going out to the local night of practice, but we'll see. There's a lot of practice needed to get out there and to win a lap here at Rock Hill, the Supercross World Cup. But right now, coming in that last turn, it looks like it's going to be Hughes and McLean battling out. Kringos is going to have made his way back up there. Looks like he's in that top three spot right now, but coming across the line, it'll be Hughes, McLean, Kringers, and Sinma will be your top four.
Sinma was working his butt off trying to get to that fourth place position. He needed the points. He was pedaling as if he was going down the first straight just there. So always an interest as we finish all of the three runs for elite men. It'll be very interesting to see how the points shake out. You can see the sun's going down. Official heat 10, Hughes, McLean, Kriegers, Sinma. Vasco with the fifth, Laborato with the sixth, Bunkayai, Lopera will most likely have to pack it up and take it home for this Supercross event.
So that wraps it up for the Elite Men's qualification races for today. We will go through here pretty soon and get our official results of who moves on to tomorrow's program. But right now, some good racing. Jason, what stood out for you in that round of motos for the elite men?
I think what stood out for me was Van Kamen and Cole Tizar. They both rode very poised. They got the gates when they needed them, and didn't back down even when they got in a little bit of trouble. So, you know, sometimes having the home track advantage can be good, but sometimes there's also a little bit of pressure because you have all your family there and they're expecting you to do well, and so it adds a little pressure. But we have the women, and they're applying pressure too. So we have Sakaki Barra, Priest, Tuckshire, Kit Watsonthine, Fleming, Thorley, and Michelson for the run three, heat one of elite women. So what do you say?
Three rounds of elite women. That's going to be determined who meets up with our top eight ladies who are in tonight's super final time trial. But here we go, as those riders are loaded in the gate. And the inside is going to be Sakaki Barra. Can she have another consistent lap? Let's go. The gate drops, and it looks like her and Tuckshire, Priest, are all going to be out front. But right now, it's going to be Sakaki Barra leading these ladies into turn number one. Nadia Priest in second, and the Diana Tuckshire's in that third place spot.
Michelson in third, Priest in second. Sakaki Barra getting pretty comfortable up front. You know, she had a great gate last moto, and this one's even better. Looks like Michelson fighting. Maybe even going to pressure for the first place. Little bit of an elbow. Sakaki Barra lacking the experience, letting her go by. Priest now pressuring for, she'll say top three, but I think we have Canada, Australia, and Germany. So Michelson with the first, Sakaki Barra with the second, and Priest and Fleming for third and fourth, respectively. And our lighting guy getting ready for the time trials. He definitely wants to shine the spotlight
on you. You're going to be down there. You're going to be down there.
I will be down there
out of the riders. So there's our official results. It was Michelin, not Tuckshire, that was out in front, as I noted. Sakabara in second, as you said, Jason. Didn't really expect her to get past on that last turn, but definitely a good run from the Canadian. And then Nadia Priest, strong as always, up there in that top three spot. So get ready for the second round here for elite women. Afremova, Reno, Ballinger, Geving, Escobar, Walsh, and Lou. Lai. Lucky. Another one of those Pokemon.
She is lucky. She's racing in this beautiful track, South Carolina. Rock Hill, great facility run by a BMX and mountain bike world champion, Mike King, as we see the women on the gate taking those final deep breaths. The starter saying, okay, riders, it's a go. Looks like the Russian hurries out of the gate, meeting up with the Canadian down the first straight. Reno getting into that second corner, or that first corner in second. We have Afremova, Reno, and Geving, top three into the second corner as they head into the rhythm section. They are spreading themselves out, getting quite comfortable in the positions they are in. Afremova, Reno, and Geving. Pete, let's bring us into the finish line.
So, yes, the young Russian girl, she's been consistently out front all day. She's going to take her third victory in three motos. She's going to come across the line. Shaylin, Reno, strong return to supercross racing with that second. Amanda Geving, again, consistently up in the front with the third place finish. And then from Colombia, it will be Escobar in fourth, Walsh from Canada in fifth, Made in China Liu for sixth, and Blenger from Canada in that seventh place finish. So there's your official results. And as we said, those top three women have been up there all day, so they're all moving on. It's going to be questionable for Escobar or Walsh. We'll see how things turn out. We just have one more moto of the elite women to go before we finish off with today's Tioga qualification show, brought to you live here on BMX Live TV with Dr. Jason Richardson. So here we go. Last run of the day for the elite women. Curtis, Schrembinger, Tongmi, Smulders, Jones, and Gonzalez. Yes, sir.
Yes. The sun is setting. The day is getting bigger, as Snoop Dogg says, and they are up.
Ooh, I like Snoop Dogg.
Standing, poised, locked and loaded. Red means race. They're off to the races, down the ramp, over the first jump. It looks like Smulders pops out quite quickly. Jones stuck out there in that fourth spot. Fellow countrywoman in second place with the Brit in third. We have Smulders coming out of the second turn, Curtis and Shriver, top three, Jones in fourth. Smulders double manual over, then to the step, and then double pumps into the last corner. Smulders is probably going to take a chill into this last straight, knowing she's in. Jones with the fourth, Shriver and Curtis fighting for the second and third. Shriver with the second and Curtis with the third. That about wraps us up.
Yeah, the younger of the Smulders sisters showed us how it's done here today in that third round of moto. Shriver from Great Britain, definitely good to see some woman talent, some young woman's talent come from Great Britain. Exciting to see. And as well as we see Curtis from Australia riding strong, Jones as well. So definitely good there. That'll wrap up the qualification runs here for the elite women. And we will get you those overall results in just a few moments. But again, good racing here from the elite women. A smaller field, but they will meet up with those top riders who are into tonight's time trial. So here are the qualifying riders for the racing after our three rounds of motos.
So for elite men, moving on, Molina, Santiago Marin, Trey White, Vide, Van Gent, Smith, Palmer, Posey. Those eight will be moving on tomorrow night's event, along with Sakakibara, Sebesta, Villegas, Hughes, Webster, Tejico, Whitfield, Van Kamen. Also strong showings from that second round of eight. So we're now we're getting the lights on. Sun has gone down. And the final men to move on. Gustafson, Tugas, Malinfant, Van Gorkum, Kriegers, Rock and Roll, Cole, Tizar, and Christensen. They will be also moving on for tomorrow night's big show.
I think there's eight more.
We might have eight more.
Eight more. So these were the ones that were right on the ledge. And you see Logan Collins will qualify.
Logan Collins gets in there.
Guys.
Bensink, Bernhardt, Montenegro, Keeman, Palominos, Rosso, and McCrory making it in by the hair of his chinny chin chin.
So definitely good to see these younger riders qualify through. As we get through one more page of qualifications, McLean, Calixto Lopez, Kronk, Martinez, Rojas, Marquardt, Bias, Sengers, and Sinma.
Last group of men, Holmes, Grunendahl, Melendez, DeMont, Shippers, Fala, Agudela, Manaton.
So they'll meet up with the other 16 riders from tonight's super final time trial, and that will set us up for tomorrow's qualification runs for the elite men. So I'm sure we'll make our way over here to elite women in just a moment to show you who moved on, as we'll get those top 16 riders.
We have a great view of the track.
So elite, our top women qualifier.
Smulders, Afremova, Shriver, Curtis, Priest, Reno, Sakakibara, and Geving will be the first eight women moving on for tomorrow night's show program.
And then you'll see 9 through 16. These are the ladies that move on. Jones, Walsh, Tuxia, Michelin, Fleming, Escobar, Thrali, and Yan Liu, the last lady to make it in. Definitely exciting to see the young woman from China make her way into tomorrow's race day format.
It's always nice to see dreams come true. It's always nice to see new, fresh participants in the sport making their way. So it's a really nice thing to see. As the sun has finally gone down, the lights will come on, and
we have about an hour break before we move on to the super final time trials. So, Jason, wrapping things up here, I got your standouts for the elite men and the elite women. Who surprised you?
Who surprised me? I believe her name is Shriver from Great Britain. Consistent gates, really good on the track. You could see that she might not have the complete experience that some of the more known names have, but I thought she was very consistent. She shows a lot of mettle, and I think we'll be seeing her getting to the main, or if not very close, tomorrow. So she was probably the biggest standout. And then of course Geving, having worked a full-time job, although, as a firewoman, I'm sure she trains quite a bit. So it's just a matter of getting her bearings on this new school racing, but definitely getting better with each lap.
So as you see that countdown clock, we've got 59 minutes before we move into those super finals. So just real quickly, we'll give you the rundown. Who's in tonight's super final? It's going to be Danny, George, Natalia Sarova, Yaroslav Badarenko, Bao, Van Hoof, Crane, Christensen, and Smulders. Those are the eight ladies in tonight's super final time trial. And then we move over to the elite men's side of things. There'll be Komarov from Russia, Upshaw, Jones, Nyhog, Vandenberg, Aquindo, Tremonis, Andre, Evans, Strongbergs, Long, Torres, Blanc, Graf, Ramirez, and Corbin Sherrar, current leader in the elite men's overall rankings. Those will be the 16 men that go in tonight's super final time trial. As we said, in just about 58 minutes, tune back in for live action from stop number 4, the UCI BMX Supercross World Cup here in Rock Hill, South Carolina, the United States of America. For Dr. Jason Richardson and myself, Pete Dulewski, we will see you back here in just about 55 minutes or so.
See you in a bit.
on it. I got it.
Yeah, must have just checked.
Yeah, okay, they just checked it.
I checked about an hour ago.
Okay.